But going back to another serious topic, it might get dark again. Rest in peace.
Oh, Jesus.
Young Dolph.
Young Dolph, man.
Very, very unfortunate. Rest in peace, Young Dolph. I was looking real quick to see if I could get his legal name. I don't see it right here, but okay, right here. Adolph Robert Thornton. Rest in peace to him. Yes, can you maybe zoom in a little bit on that, Marge? Mm-hmm. But here we have him. Unfortunately, in his purest form, the man was a father, two children, a wife. I'm not sure if they were married, but it's a wife. You could say it's a wife because that's his lady. Much respect to them, and our prayers are with you guys. I know the mourning has been and has to be very crazy. So Young Dolph has passed away in the city of Memphis, Tennessee. He, what specific day? I'm gonna actually get the specific day because it did feel to me as if it was
It was on Wednesday.
On Wednesday?
No, not Wednesday.
November. Okay, it was Wednesday. November 17th.
It was Wednesday.
Yes, on November 17th exactly. He was 36 years old. He was buying cookies from Makita's Butter Cookies in Memphis. Very classic little spot, especially for him because he was a frequent visitor. He would post it up that he was visiting.
Yeah,
they used
he would
him
post
in promotion.
It up.
Yeah, they
he would,
used
he would promote it. He would promote
wow.
it.
Yeah, they would use him in promotion. Like, Young Dolph's here, yeah. guys, blah, blah, because wow. he loved it. And people were saying it might have been supposedly he gets them for his mother, something like that. So he was there getting cookies for his mother.
Ooh. Fuck, niggas can't even go and get cookies nowadays, dog.
In a car. It was alleged, but now it's confirmed because we saw the footage and the photos. We might have to put the photos up eventually. I'm going to snitch on them, niggas. I hope they get caught. But we have, it was an actual car that drove up to the storefront and shots rang out. They had like a Draco and like a AK, like they had multiple guns. They were very, equipped assault rifles and they were actually ready with, their attire, like on some let's get out of here, like little bummy fits and vibes, mask on their face. The car that they shot up, that they did the crime in, the it was like a Mercedes Benz.
It was
got
a Mercedes.
Found. They found it in like someone's backyard randomly. So now they're gonna run prints and shit. They're gonna keep the investigation going. So most likely these people are gonna get caught.
Did y'all hear that? Supposedly, one of his securities actually managed to shoot. So supposedly, I don't know if it's true.
Yeah, I didn't see that confirmed yet. But people were saying that.
And,
yeah, someone was shooting back. Hopefully,
and apparently the person died or something. I don't really know.
Hopefully that was sort of the case because you always want to. People will say like, "Oh, at least he went out shooting, whatever, defending himself." But at the end of the day, the man did just die. So
the security died.
No. The Young
just
Dolph.
Young Dolph.
Young Dolph died.
Was it just him? Just only Young Dolph?
Yeah, I think. Yeah. I think. I'm not sure. I didn't hear nothing about him when I was getting injured. It would have been reported more. I would have saw it. But especially if that's the case, that's crazy because that confirms without it necessarily being confirmed. Allegedly,
it was a hit.
It's a hit.
It's a hit. 100% it was a hit.
It's a plan to kill. It's not like a, oh, that's Young Dolph. Let's get him. It's like, oh, we know he comes to Madikas. Let's go and kill him at
Madikas.
Listen,
bro, the internet speaks, man. The amount of videos and posts I've seen of, like, the internet, like, putting two and two together and, like, naming people and showing.
Amazing.
It's crazy.
The internet, man, especially in this day and age, that's why I always say, like, you can't necessarily be these things that they make movies out of, like a serial killer, etc. None of that shit exists no more because people, you can't with this fucking internet age and everything that's happening right now with the, what was that girl that was lost and it was like all over the news, a white girl that was lost and
the
guy.
Again?
Yeah, and they were looking for her and they were looking for the guy too because the guy ended up getting lost and then ended up found them, they were both dead, both their bodies. During that search, they found like six more other bodies that had nothing to do with the search.
And one of them,
one
from
of them
Providence,
was
from
here.
Yeah.
One of the guys was from Providence. Yeah. Yeah. So it's like, that
in
those might have been.
North
yeah,
Carolina?
I think in North Carolina. North I think Carolina. All the way over there. North Carolina is a bad state. God bless. But jokes. But when it comes to that specifically, it's like, yeah, man, everything's going to be caught and people are going to speak. And the internet has spoken. Very viral, very big news online. A lot of people showing their love and appreciation for Young Dolph. Even if you didn't hear about his music, you're definitely familiar with him now, not just because he died, but because the people that have been acknowledging his death from Drake, every artist, Gucci Mane, every artist, there's been tremendous respect for him because he was someone that put basically Memphis on the map, especially the younger generation. Like, he was the one that a lot of these motherfuckers looked up to, specifically.
He was smart, too.
Yeah, specifically. Yeah. Can you put up the photo I have of Key Glock? He finally posted literally a couple hours ago on his story. Here we have him. Stop asking me if I'm okay, knowing damn well I ain't, with a heartbroken emoji. This is Key Glock, his cousin, his artist, who recently dropped a project and is amongst the young, amongst the hottest young artists. By default, Key Glock. So people have been waiting for Key Glock. Like, he deleted his posts, he deactivated his pages. What's happening with Key Glock? Allegedly, is he gonna go kill these motherfuckers? Allegedly, is he just sad? What's going on? he's sad. Here we have it, man. He's literally sad, man. This is not easy to deal with. This was this motherfucker's spitting image when it came to even aesthetically, his style of rap.
Yeah.
Like, he was like his prodigy, and this motherfucker, people would confuse them, and it's like, it didn't even like diminish neither of their careers. They both were hot. Whenever they dropped, they dropped.
Yeah.
They were independent and still were buzzing. Always been independent since day one. And so it's like, come on.
And what I think people don't understand is what we cover is a lot of mainstream shit. These guys, like, these guys are huge, but they're regional.
Yes.
You know what I'm saying? They're regional. There's nothing wrong with that. We're more from, like, the New York East Coast. So it's like, if anything, if we would do regional artists, it would be more from up here.
Yes.
But we know of these people. And we Memphis know, like, artists. Of course, like, we're
and Memphis
very
is bound to rise, you know.
Yeah, 100%. And that hurts us because these people are so big from where they're from. Mm-hmm. Huge, bro.
I think
huge.
It's Pushaisi. Pushaisi from Memphis, I believe. Pushaisi's locked up right now. Free poo-poo. Not poo-poo. God bless. Pushaisi. Free Pushaisi is locked up right now, I believe.
And Pushaisi almost had a similar incident like that, too.
Yeah, and a lot of these motherfuckers are from Memphis, man. Memphis is one of the most hottest cities in music, if not the most hottest right now, especially during the last year where we had Moneybagg Yo, Pusheasy, Big 30, ESTG, I believe is from Memphis.
Yeah.
Please correct me if I'm wrong in the comments. Mm-hmm. Yo Gotti, Black Youngsta, that whole camp, which unfortunately has had a past history with
Young
Dolph.
Is NBA YoungBoy from Memphis?
No, he's from New Orleans. Orleans, because of Kevin Gates Connect. Man, prayers. Hopefully, there's no really real deal connection with the Yo Gotti situation, because I see Yo Gotti as someone who's also been respected on some CEO shit.
Yeah.
Bossing Up has now connections with the Jay-Z and is on some real deal millionaire. He owns like a soccer team now. He's part owner of a soccer team. So when it comes to that, it's like, bro, people can talk all they want to talk online, right? But we got to wait until the facts come out. As of now, he hasn't spoken. And it's also like, it could be a case where he could have no affiliation to what literally happened and just not speak for legal purposes, because people are going to assume, you know, even if he says rest in peace, whatever, they're going to use that maybe in court, you know. But it's like, let's hopefully not use that in court. Let's not have to use nothing in court. But there's rumors of his Yo Gotti's restaurant, his mother's restaurant, his restaurant that he owns, and Black Youngster's mother's house being shot up.
Grandma,
like these places, these places in Memphis being shot up by people. Now, I don't know if it's because we're retaliating, or maybe because we're Young Dolph's little homies and we might think we have a hunch, so we're going to just shoot these motherfuckers places up. I don't want that to happen.
What if it's
very
just
sad.
Some niggas just going on a spree trying to get these rappers?
That's what I'm thinking. Like, it could be someone else. Like, you don't know. We don't really necessarily know. And until they get caught, we will not know. And let the fucking people, the cops do them their shit. If people want to do street justice, do street justice. But hey,
I don't know, man. Violence begins violence.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, man. They did violence a curfew in Memphis. Violence. Like, I think it's still going on, the curfew. Like, they have to go home by a certain time because they know how serious and dangerous the city can get. And we do not want that to happen. It's not something that should be applauded or commended.
These niggas is huge, bro.
Yeah,
these
man.
These niggas is huge from where they're from.
They're very huge,
so God bless them.
I love Young Dolph. I ain't gonna lie.
Didn't he have a really good
Dolph!
He had a good interview with Wallow, no?
Pretty recent. Had a bunch of good interviews, man. Yeah. He's a good freestyler. He went on Tim Westwood. You got to watch it. The Tim Westwood freestyle he did, off the top, nigga. Off the top. And it was like, he was just rapping about shit, like, around him. And his flow was always so hard. And then Key Glock went, and then he went back. Right. And, like, you could see the similarities always. Like, it's very, like, he was always seeding Key Glock. And now the pressure's on Key Glock. I'm not going to lie to you. Unfortunate. Rest in peace to Dolph. But it's, like, now the passing of the torch at a very forced type of situation. It's not necessarily planned. And Key Glock, in his interviews, will always talk about, like, yeah, I'm still street. Like, I'm not out the streets. Like, I'm 1 foot in the streets, 1 foot out the thing. I hope you're not in the streets, my
Better
brother. I hope you get that foot out the motherfucking streets, because we do not want to see you pass away at any one of your affiliates. We saw, put the photo if you can, is in the notes. His team was still doing the Thanksgiving drive, giving away turkeys. Here we have it. Young Dolph's artist. I forgot their label name.
I think it's sad, man.
Yeah, man. Look at this. So they still did it because I think it was already slated for the next day or 2 days after he died.
Mm-hmm.
So they were like, yo, we're still going to do it. And I think a day after he died, he was going to meet with the city for something. And like a week before, he met with the city and did an interview with the city, with like the council. This motherfucker was on the right path. This is someone that was on some Nipsey shit. There's a lot of similarities with Nipsey and his city, and then L.A. in general, with Dolph and Memphis, if we're being very honest. And I love that, because it's like, yo, at least, at the very least, we have an optimistic side where it's like, what he's leaving behind is positive energy.
Yeah.
And we see these young men right here, these young gentlemen, not no fucking thugs, however you want to categorize them. These are young men actually caring about the community, and continuing what their leader and their OG was doing. I love this. This is dope, man. This is 100%. Always a thing. Like, artists do this, and it's dope that they're still doing it. You know, people need this in time of need. Like, they need the giveaway. They need this. And there was a lot of emotional interviews by community people, young fans crying in the streets of Memphis, like, oh, my God, I can't believe he died, and the little kids crying. And then women, like mothers coming out, speaking about the law. I guess recently, the past couple months, there was a law passed in Tennessee or maybe Memphis. Correct me in the comments. But I know the law, wherever it was placed, you don't need a license or nothing to carry a gun. You could just buy a gun like as you're buying water. You don't need shit on some Texas shit. I think Texas passed it recently, right? Remember?
But
I think
Texas passed it recently.
They,
like
they have open carry.
Open carry.
Yeah.
Isn't it specific guns? Then it has to be. I can't believe a nigga could just walk around with an assault rifle from
I think you can. I think it's just like real deal. Yeah, because when I go to the, out here, you can buy a gun. You could just buy a gun. Yeah, they don't limit me. I could buy the big one or the small one. I swear to God, you could buy whatever you want. You guys want the big one over there? What does that one do? I don't know what that one does, but I can show you. You didn't have to know.
It's easy as fuck. It's easy as fuck to buy shit.
It's very so. If it's easy here, imagine over there. They just handed it out like candy. Very unfortunate. So the community is in a disarray. It's
up in arms.
Rest in peace to Young Dolph. This shit is not a fucking game. You motherfuckers, please stay safe and cut the crap. Let's not encourage this. And maybe, I'm not going to lie, there might be a deeper conversation. We'll get into it another day. But the music is going to have to start changing. I'm not going to lie to you. Because it's like Snoop said in his interview, when Biggie and Pac died and people around him were dying, and specifically him, when he spoke about murder was a case and stuff, and like, that was before his murder case. And he was like, damn, I spoke that into existence. He's like, there's power in your words. Mm-hmm. There's power in the things that you put out there. Mm-hmm. So you have to be careful with your art. I know it's art. I understand that. It's not literal. I don't want it to be used in court. They use it now, but now they're gonna pass a law soon where you can't use it in court, people's lyrics. Mm. But they've been using it recently, right? So I think that's unfortunate. But it is like you're dry snitching on yourself. But it's art.
It's true, though. Pop Smoke.
We got to be honest. We have to talk about it. Juice WRLD always talking about he was doing these drugs and I need help and I'm already dead. Mm-hmm. Motherfucker, you're dead. God bless. And look at you were talking about it.
This nigga from Chicago. Goddamn. This nigga, goddamn. What's the nigga?
Pass away?
Yeah, the nigga from Chicago.
Oh, Vaughn. King Vaughn. Yeah, King Vaughn. So I'll do it to you, whatever. Yeah. Catch you lacking, blah, blah, blah. Unfortunately, you were caught lacking. God bless. Like, it's happening. Yeah. These things that you're actually talking about is actually happening.
Yeah.
So we're not really going to talk about that. It's a serious discussion. We're going to have to save it for another day. But I pray for everyone involved. And, yeah, man, let's keep driving through this thing called life, because this is a hell of a one. You know, we're witnessing this shit before our eyes. All these artists we listen to are passing away. And it's crazy, man. It's
moving
crazy.
Forward.
Yeah, man. God bless and rest in peace.
They going to love me for my ambition.